In this chapter, you will learn the uses of natural gas, why natural gas is dehydrated, where dehydration occurs, what triethylene glycol is, the dehydration process, and the flow of fluids through a dehydration system. What is dehydration? You may think of physical dehydration, where your body has a shortage of water, or it may remind you of dehydrated fruit or meat that has had the water removed. In natural gas dehydration, it is the same idea. Producers dehydrate gas by removing the water from it. Natural gas is used for heat, cooking, manufacturing, transportation, and to generate electricity. However, none of these things would be possible if the water content of the gas were too high. Dehydration is used for two primary reasons: to remove water vapor from natural gas to a level mandated by the purchaser, to prevent damage to gas pipelines that result when water accumulates in the system. Gas dehydration takes place anywhere natural gas contains water vapor, which could cause the quality of the gas to be below contractual agreements or safety standards. All three sectors of the oil and gas industry use dehydration, including upstream at individual well locations, midstream at gathering stations and delivery points, and downstream at processing plants. To take the water out of natural gas, producers use a liquid called triethylene glycol, also known as TEG. When gas comes into contact with the triethylene glycol, the water vapors entrained in the gas are absorbed in the TEG. In effect, the glycol soaks up the water. The glycol is then removed from the gas stream for processing so that it can be purified and reused. There is a lot of equipment needed for the dehydration process. Natural gas only travels through the inlet scrubber and the contactor tower. On some sites, these two vessels are combined into one unit. All the other equipment is used to regenerate the glycol. As the glycol moves through the contactor tower, it absorbs the moisture from the natural gas. At this point, it is referred to as either rich or wet glycol. Now it must be distilled in order to be reused. The glycol then flows into a three-phase flash separator, which separates the rich glycol from the contaminants, lubrication oil, free water, and condensate. The contaminated liquids exit and are removed to storage tanks, while the glycol then goes to the reboiler. The reboiler's distillation process removes the water contained in the wet glycol. Distilling the triethylene glycol in the reboiler is easily accomplished because of the extreme differences in boiling points of water and glycol. Water boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit, while glycol boils at 550 degrees Fahrenheit. However, TEG begins to degrade at 404 degrees Fahrenheit, which is its critical temperature. Due to the degradation temperature of TEG, producers heat the wet glycol between 212 degrees and 400 degrees. This allows the water to be boiled off and the glycol to be distilled to an appropriate level of purity so that it can be reused. The water flashes off as steam, but the glycol remains in the reboiler. Glycol in this stage is now referred to as lean or dry glycol. With the right equipment, the wet glycol can be regenerated to more than 99% purity. With good filtration, this allows producers to reuse it repeatedly, around 18 to 24 months before it needs to be changed. Dehydration units vary in size depending on gas flow. In a unit this size, the flow rate can be a few million cubic feet per day. A large dehydration system located at a central gathering station like this one can dehydrate hundreds of millions of cubic feet of gas every day.